California reopens. Many events are coming back to San Diego. So what does the future hold for this year's Over the Line tournament? Joining us to discuss whether teams will take to the sand this year is the first vice president of the Old Mission Beach Athletic Club, Mr. Tom Doyle. Mr. Doyle, good morning to you, sir.
Morning, Paul. How are you?
I am well. As a person who, when first came to town, experienced OTL and my jaw went... It is so San Diego. It is so darn special to the community that I'm kind of hoping that you have good news for us right now.
We do have good news. As of now, we've been working with the city to make sure we have the safest way possible to put on the 68th annual Over the Line World Championships this summer down at Fiesta Island. We've worked with the city hand in hand to make sure that we're charting the best path to have the safest event possible. To make sure everyone knows that we want to make sure we put on our fun event that we get to have every year that we so desperately missed out on last summer. And at the same time, make sure that we are, helping people understand the importance of being safe in their community, doing vaccinations whenever possible, making sure they have negative COVID tests, make sure they're safe when they come out to the sand. To see us, play the greatest game in San Diego, to be honest.
And it certainly is. It is so San Diego. For those, I don't need to tell people. Everyone knows how cool it is. But correct me if I'm wrong, sir, but the event is outdoors. It's spread over 2 weekends. It's the CDC has said now that we can be amongst one another. What guidelines can the city possibly offer that are needed at this hour?
So we're trying to follow some of the guidelines that the city's recommending, where we want to make sure people are as safe as possible. We're trying to encourage people to be vaccinated. We're encouraging people to have negative COVID tests. The event is outdoors. We do still qualify as one of the mega events of, over 10,000 people or more. So we want to make sure we're always stressing safety when considering our participants that are playing on the teams and also our, guests and customers who come out, whether it's in an RV spot or someone who comes out to the day for the day to watch a friend of theirs or just to see Over the Line in person, because it really is one of those San Diego events that you really do want to see at some point.
Absolutely. But are you being held to a higher standard than, say, the folks going to Petco Park?
I don't know if that's true. I know we're working with the city hand in hand. We have a team of people working with the special events permit office and the mayor's office, and they've been phenomenal to work with. Any question we've had, they've been able to talk to us and work through the answers to make sure we have what is the best outline for a safe event to put on this summer, to make sure that people still get to experience Over the Line in San Diego. We aren't doing a full 2-weekend event. We actually changed up and we're going to have our Junior Over the Line World Championships the first weekend. The adults will play the second weekend, which will really be the third weekend of July. We'll start on Friday the 16th with our men's open. Teams playing then, and then we'll move into the other teams, like the men's century and women's open will start Saturday, and we'll wrap everything up on Sunday.
So now, is that because of the number of teams you're expecting that you don't need as much playing time
or as many weekends? Correct. Just with the reduced number of teams we're putting in for this year's tournament, somewhere around 600 is kind of the number we're shooting for. We want to make sure we can pull off a good, strong tournament in one weekend. And make sure people still get to have the good time they're used to having down at the sand at Fiesta Island.
Now, is that a restriction or a number of contestants? Is that something you're putting a cap on, or is that just people are slow to come back from COVID?
That's a number we're putting a cap on. We opened up the signups last Saturday, and I believe we're over 400 teams as of now. So there aren't too many spots remaining. So anyone who's interested in playing, make sure you go to onback.org. Check out the registration link for events.com. Get your team signed up as soon as you can. And if you're a returning player who is seeded or a pre-app team or any of those teams that are used to playing in our tournament, get signed up now because spots are going fast. And if we run out, sadly, you won't get to play this year.
And just to bury, just so I'm not burying the lead, there's going to be an Over the Line tournament. We can't officially say so at this hour.
Correct. We are planning on having an Over the Line tournament. The city has been working with us to make sure we are good to go for it. We don't have a bright, big green light in front of us saying, yes, do it, go crazy. But we've been working with the city. We feel like we're in a really good spot. We appreciate the support we've gotten from the city in helping us plan this event.
Well, it's one of the pillars of the community, and OMBAC is one of the pillars of the community. It just doesn't feel like summer if there isn't an over-the-line tournament. So I hope the wind is at your back at this, and hopefully come the next year, we're back to being just the over-the-line tournament.
Absolutely. We want to get back to normal.
All right, Tom, thank you very much for making time for KUSI.
Thanks, Paul. Have a great day.